2 days out, 2023 Mr. Olympia. We're back here, Kissimmee Muscle Gym. We're getting some back in, a little more shoulders and chest, trying to pump up that upper body, force those carbs in the muscle to really set us up for our peak on Saturday.
Going into this year's Olympia, about 6 months out, 7 months out, when I decided I was gonna do it, my mindset wasn't at its best. I wasn't living my life at its potential, and my thought process going to this Olympia was trying to regain a lot of the disciplines of bodybuilding and applying those to my life throughout this journey and pushing through all the obstacles and hard times and overcoming them. I knew going into a prep and facing something as steep as returning to the Olympia stage was the nudge that I needed to get myself back into a mindset of becoming a champion and overcoming everything that life throws at me. The moment where everything started feeling really very real was the moment that my name got announced at the press conference, when I heard the announcer say, the four-time champion making his return after 5 years, Jeremy Buendia, and then hearing the crowd erupt. Just that moment of getting up there underneath those lights and seeing the auditorium packed with all those people cheering for me. It just shows how far I've come. It felt like the world hated me for so long. I hated myself for so long. I was proud.
Please welcome the comeback kid from the United States, Jeremy Buendia.
Jeremy, you're trying to do something that some legendary bodybuilders have tried and failed.
I feel I'm in the best spot I've been in my entire life right now. I think a lot of people forget that I was in my early 20s when I won my first Olympia. When I lost my Olympia title, I was only 27 years old. And at that point in time in my life, I was still trying to figure out who I was and, you know, what my role was in this life and my purpose. And, you know, after I lost my title, I kind of lost my way for a while, made some poor choices, and spiraled out for a little while. And I found myself in a kind of a slump, in a hole for a couple of years that, you know, it was very hard for me to get out of. And there's a reason why I didn't make my way back to the stage, because physically I've been dealing with injuries, but also the mental aspect of things of dealing with my mental health and trying to be a better person. And
I wanted people to understand what this journey meant to me and where I came from, because I know a lot of people wrestle with guilt in their past and wrestle with things that happened in the past. And a lot of the times, you need somebody to give you a push, to motivate you to get yourself out of that hole. You need a little inspiration. And like I said, I wasn't planning on saying any of the things that I said. It's my experiences, and I'm just grateful that I was able to voice them and articulate them in an eloquent way that people were able to perceive them and understand them and relate to them.
The beginning of this prep, I didn't believe I can do it. You know, my body has been through a lot. Mentally, I wasn't in a good space, and from what everybody was telling me, that the division had outgrown me. And I had been told that I wasn't wanted back. And when you're getting told something over and over again, you start to believe it. And when you start to believe what other people put in your head, you start to lose sight of what your true self is. If you are going through a hard time in life and you're finding yourself in a slump that you can't pull yourself out of, you don't have to stay there. You don't have to stay there. There is opportunities, there is a redeemer, and there's a way of finding your way back out. And that's something that I've been able to do these past several months, is been able to rebuild myself from the inside out. And mentally, I'm the strongest I've ever been. And on Saturday, you're gonna see me physically the strongest I've ever been.
Well, Jeremy, welcome back to the Olympia stage, brother.
Yes.
Daddy, it's so fun.
It was fun.
Yeah, the graffiti.
I knew I had fans, but I really didn't know what to expect showing up at Olympia. Like, how many people are really going to come up to see me and want to meet me in person and talk to me? So when we went to meet the Olympians, the line, I don't know, people were waiting 30, 45 minutes to meet me at least in my line. And that was from the beginning to end. And it felt really good to be stepping away from the stage for 5 years and to have that amount of support and to see that I have fans. Having the amount of fans and supporters at Meet the Olympians was incredible. It was amazing, and it just reminded me of why I work so hard and why I've tried to why I've made so many changes in my life is because I do have a long line of people that are waiting to meet me and waiting to follow me. So I will continue to be my best every single day. I will continue to set a good example, and I'll continue to motivate and inspire you guys to be your best.
Did you see it yesterday?
Oh yeah.
Let me go in here and see about getting darker than Jeremy.
I just got my first coat of tan on. Looks great. Pro Tan always does a great job. A little sneak peek at the conditioning and color. But I'm going to go back home. I'm going to get some rest. I got to get all packed up because we're, like I said before, we're staying like 40 minutes away. So I got to get all my food ready for tomorrow. Get all the stuff. Make sure to go through my checklist. I don't forget anything. And we're going to come back out here at like 7:15 in the morning, get my last coat of tan, and we're going to be hanging out in my buddy's rooms until showtime. So that's very much a wrap for the day. Not much more to do, but just mentally focus, zone in, and start visualizing the victory.
The amount of support I have had over the course of the last 5 months has been unbelievable. And DQ and I came together, and we decided to make a board short, the first ever board short by Vanquish. And one of the biggest things that drew inspiration from these shorts were my previous Olympias. You know, I've had four titles. I turned pro and did my very first Olympia in a black and orange pair of shorts. And that's where this colorway came from. And then I also won multiple Olympias wearing black and blue shorts. And that's where we got this colorway from. As far as the design goes, you know, I have lightning bolts on my arm, and then also my client who's competing with me, Jovan Sagabayan, who's like my brother from the Philippines, he came out a few months ago on stage with a pair of shorts that had some lightning bolts on them, and they looked amazing. The best thing I like about these shorts is they're a 15-inch cut, and as you guys know, the men's physique division has made some changes in the rules, and they were going to start highlighting the legs here in 2024. So we wanted the shorter cut on this short to show a little bit more of the bottom of the quad, and it also has the scalloped side right here to help bring up a little bit higher on the leg to give you a little bit more pop. You know, these shorts also will highlight the aesthetics of the physique just based off the design of the way we shaped the lightning bolts and the color. You're gonna see it's gonna sweep around legs, so it's gonna help develop that X frame around your quads and into the hip. It's gonna help accentuate a smaller waist and a better taper. So when it comes to a competition board short, you know, I've been doing this a long time. I know what helped make the physique pop, and this is definitely going to help highlight my strengths and my physique, and I'm sure it's going to highlight a lot of you guys that put these on as well. But I'm very, very proud to have been able to be a contributing factor in designing these shorts that are absolutely beautiful. I think that we're going to be seeing these on the stage all across the world in 2024. The Jeremy Buendia Vanquish Fitness Collaboration Board Short.
Favorite part is I shave my whole body. This is right up there with the worst part of bodybuilding is tanning.
On point, ready for five, and that's not something I say easily. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for bringing us here today. Father, we just ask that you complete Jeremy's journey. We know you've been watching after. We love you so much for it, Father.
You know, every Olympia my family is out, we always pray before I go on stage. And, you know, prayer has always been something that we've had in our home. You know, I grew up, you know, with faith in my family. And every night at dinner, we'd pray before we'd eat. At Olympia, we've made it a tradition to pray before I go on stage. And, you know, we just pray for guidance. We pray for strength. We pray for performance. We pray for understanding, you know, that whatever happens, to always give glory back to God and understand that his plan for us is better than ours. That's the gist of what we pray for. And just giving thanks to him for everything that he's helped get me through to get back to this point. I appreciate I'm able to do that with my family. You know, it means a lot. It does a lot for me before I go on stage. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Say amen, Daddy. You got this, Daddy.
Love you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your next competitor from the USA, former four-time Olympia champion, the return of Jeremy Buendia. Welcome back to the Olympia stage, Jeremy.
When I woke up Saturday morning for pre-judging, I did not feel my best. I woke up feeling like, oh shit, like I'm not feeling very good right now. Like this is, my stomach doesn't feel good. This is not how I want to feel going onto stage. So, you know, I just kept moving forward. I didn't look terrible. You know, I felt like I looked good. But as we started eating, my body wasn't digesting the food because I hadn't gone to the bathroom yet, and the food was stacking on top of each other, and I could feel my body kind of getting more watery and not digesting the food, not filling out the way it needed. And I knew when I took off my shirt and started pumping up that my conditioning wasn't at its peak. It wasn't where I needed to be. So I was stressing out a lot. I was nervous, you guys. It was my first time back on stage in 5 years. The guys look amazing. This level of competition, you guys, is like I've never seen before. These guys are the best in the world for a reason. All of them look incredible, all of them. So it's hard when you step backstage and you're seeing 46 of the best men's physique bodies on the planet. It can get in your head a little bit, especially being away for 5 years, not knowing how you're gonna stack up.
All right, here we go, Big Steve.
Thank you, Bob. In numerical order, 6, 21, 22, 23, 33, 34, 43, and 46. Six switch, please.
46. So walking on that stage, you know, my posing was a little nervous. You can see it in my face a little bit. My breathing was off. But once I got through that first comparison and my posing routine, I managed to settle down a little bit. But unfortunately, at that time, the judging had already been done. And, you know, my body wasn't where it needed to be. And I was really frustrated. So, you know, after we got off stage, you know, the nerves and pressure kind of fell off a little bit and it kind of decreased, and I kind of knew I wasn't gonna win at that point. So it was kind of like, let's just enjoy the rest of the day. Cheese sandwiches and pizza. Taco Bell. But for sweets, I haven't even mentioned salt. I've been wanting homemade chocolate chip cookies. My wife is probably the best baker I've ever tasted. And she made these last night, and I was like, babe, that's the one thing I'm craving. She's like, oh no, I'm so sorry. But now I'm happy she made them. I haven't had a cookie in probably 6 months. Back here now at finals, you guys. We didn't do too much filming after prejudging, to be honest. A lot of mixed emotions about prejudging went. You know, obviously I compete to win, and I came here with a plan to walk away as the winner. And after prejudging, I wasn't called back to the top four. I found myself in the first call out in the top eight. They did a confirmation round, and I wasn't in the last standing four, so that was a hard pill to swallow because I've never been in that position before. So when I got off stage, I just kind of need some time to process and take it all in. And overall, this has been about the journey the entire time and the lessons I've been learning along the way. And even today is a lesson that I'm being taught, that, you know, even when things don't go your way, you still have to be able to figure out how to navigate through those waters and be as productive as possible and find the good in whatever you can, because there is. So, you know, I'm still searching for those answers at the moment right now, but coming back here to finals and seeing this main stage just reminds me of all the accomplishments I've had along the way and how far away I was at one point from being here. And to be able to come back and be in the top 10 best in the world in this division, which is far bigger than it ever has been, says a lot. And you know, I'm hungry. I'm disappointed in the fact that I wasn't in the top four at prejudging, because, you know, I'm a winner, I'm a champion, and it's in my blood to strive to be the best. But in life, not everything works out the way you want. So when the things don't happen the way that you want them to happen, you still gotta move forward, you still gotta pick yourself up, and still gotta do your best from that point on. So here we are, finals. I'm gonna go back on that stage and fight for the highest placing that I can. You know, prejudging, like I said, they had me at a 7 or an 8, and if I can battle into that fifth spot tonight, that'll be something amazing. So that's what we're gonna go fight for right now. We're about probably 2 or 3 hours away from stage time. So I'm gonna go back there to rest up and just mentally prepare myself. So you win some, you lose some, of you guys, but it's all about your perspective and how you move forward. So we're gonna move forward as a winner. Let's go.
USA, former four-time Olympia champion, Jeremy Buendia.
So I walked out there. I just wanted to showcase, you know, my best physique. Was the finals my best physique? Nah, I was like 80, 85%. I could have been better, but I was proud of it. You know, I walked back out there and I looked good. I felt good. I posed good. The pictures and videos looked great. That's what I wanted. I wanted people to see my hard work and see it pay off. And at nighttime, it made it happen. But like I said, it matters more in prejudging. And I was told, you know, if I would have looked the way I looked at nighttime in the morning, I would have placed a little bit higher. So that gives me a lot of hope, you guys. Like, it really does. I really believe I can still come back and win the Mr. Olympia. I really do. My physique is not far behind. It's a matter of fixing a few things, making some adjustments in my back. You know, I didn't train my core, midsection, or lower back because of the injuries I've had. I'm gonna really take time off season, get my lower body fixed, get my core fixed, my back fixed, start strengthening those little things, working on the details. And, you know, we're gonna come back better next year. My coach Wadi and I collected a lot of data from this prep. Me and Wadi, you know, this has been our first, you know, 4 or 5 months of truly working closely together, so it takes some time. We're gonna do things a lot differently this next prep, and we already kind of have a game plan of what we're gonna do. But then again, every prep is different, your body evolves, so we're always gonna have to reassess. Moving forward from this point, I feel real confident with things. You know, I think this is taking a lot of pressure off of me. I think I'm gonna have a lot of fun competing. You guys are probably gonna see me on the pro circuit, traveling around doing some shows next year for the first time ever. I think that's gonna be a lot of fun for us, and I'm gonna be able to create a lot of awesome content for you guys along the way. There's a lot of good that's gonna come out of this. There really is, and you guys stay watching, because 2024, I'm coming back. I'm coming back to win the Olympia. I'm gonna show you guys that I'm gonna keep getting better. I did this in less than a year, you guys, coming back from where I was at. Less than a year. Give me one more year. You guys saw what happened in the last 3 months. Imagine me applying all that for the next 11 months till the next Olympia. Good luck, Ryan Terry, because I'm coming after you in that Olympia title, brother.
Down, levitate, going up, elevate, watch me demonstrate, on time, never late.